everyone. Thanks for joining us today. I'm Nikki, and I'm so excited to be sharing our Sunday school video with you. I want you to think about what it's like growing up. Growing up can be really exciting. However, sometimes growing up can mean more responsibility, which can be a bit scary. Today, we're going to learn about a prophet of God who feared he was too young to share God's message with God's people. Something that is considered state-of-the-art 1 year may be considered old or useless when a newer version is created. Today, we'll learn about a time that God promised to make a new and better covenant with his people. Why might a new one be better? Let's take a break and finish our activity page. Look at each of the items on the sheet and then draw what the newer and better version of that technology would look like. At different ages, we have different things expected of us. When a baby throws a fit, it's very different than if an adult does the same thing. But there are also many things you cannot do until you're older, like voting or driving. Today, we'll learn about a prophet who was concerned about his age. But before we get into the story, why don't we play a game? Pause the video and each of you take turns acting out something that you did when you were a baby, but you no longer do. And the other person will try to guess what it was. We've been learning about God's plan. Who remembers our big picture question and answer? Great. How did God plan to fix what sin broke? Before he created the world, God planned to send the Messiah to save sinners. That means that God knew we chose to disobey him, and yet he still chose to create us and give us freedom to make our own choices and send Jesus to rescue us when we choose sin. What a good and loving God he is. Speaking of people choosing to sin, God's people were again living in sin. They had rejected God and were living as two separate kingdoms, Israel in the north and Judah to the south. Despite Judah's sin, God sent prophets to call them back to God. The prophet Isaiah told about the Messiah, and not all the kings were bad. Hezekiah and Josiah led the prophet back to God, but the occasional good kings were not enough to save God's people. The people could not obey God's law perfectly, and God's covenant with them required perfect obedience. So that's where our story picks up.
When Josiah was the king of Judah, God called a priest named Jeremiah to be a prophet. God told Jeremiah, "I knew you before I made you in your mother's womb. Before you were born, I chose you to do very special things. I chose you to be a prophet to the nations." "Oh no, God," Jeremiah said. "I don't know how to speak in front of other people. I am just a boy, only a youth." "Don't say that," God replied. "You will go where I send you and say what I tell you to say. I am with you. I will protect you."
For many years, Jeremiah spoke God's message to the people of Judah. He reminded them that God had made a covenant with them. If they obeyed him, he would bless them. But the people did not obey. Now God had to punish their sin. God said the people would lose their land, their wealth, and their freedom.
Jeremiah explained that people's hearts fool them into thinking they are better than they actually are. They trick people into wanting things or doing things that God does not want for them. The people did not want to listen to Jeremiah, and Jeremiah was sad. He warned them that God's punishment was coming, but he also said that God had a plan to change his people's hearts. God promised a new and better covenant so the people could be saved from their sins. God would write his law on people's hearts. He would give his people power to obey his commands. God said, "I will forgive their wrongdoing and never again remember their sin."
God told Jeremiah to write God's message on a scroll. So Jeremiah spoke God's words, and his friend Baruch wrote the words on a scroll. Baruch read from the scroll so that all the people heard God's words. He warned that the king of Babylon would come and destroy Judah.
King Jehoiakim sent one of his officials to get the scroll. As the official read the scroll, King Jehoiakim cut off each part of the scroll and threw it into the fire. He did this until the entire scroll was burned up. So God told Jeremiah to write another scroll with the same words as the first scroll. Jeremiah told the king, God is going to punish you, your family, and your leaders for doing wrong things. God warned you this disaster will come to Judah, but you did not listen.
Jeremiah told about a day when God would forgive sin and change people's hearts. Jesus made these words come true. God forgives our sin through his Son, Jesus. He changes us and gives us power through his Spirit to obey his commands.
The covenant God made with Israel meant that God would bless them as long as they obeyed him. If they did not, he would punish their sin. Even though God's rules were clear, the people did not listen to him or obey the law. They deserved death because of their sin. They sinned and sinned, and God showed them mercy, giving many warnings and multiple chances to repent, but they still disobeyed. Jeremiah told the people to expect punishment, but Jeremiah also offered the people hope. Jeremiah told God's people about a new and a better covenant. In the old covenant, the people obeyed God to gain his blessings, but in the new covenant, God would pour out blessings so that people could obey. Instead of having the law on scrolls, God would put the law in their hearts. God would even give them the power they needed to be able to obey. The new covenant would be amazing, much better than the old one. And do you know what? The new covenant is already here. Jeremiah told about a day when God would forgive sin and change people's hearts. Jesus made these words come true. God forgives our sins through his Son, Jesus. He changes us and gives us power through his Spirit to obey his commands. Jesus brought about the new covenant. He lived a perfect life with no sin, obeying the law perfectly. Then Jesus died on the cross for our sin and rose again on the third day to defeat death. After Jesus went back to heaven, he sent the Holy Spirit, who lives in believers, to help us love and obey God. God sent Jesus to deal with our sin once and for all by dying and rising again. Let's worship him for his goodness and love. So everyone, let's stand up and sing together.
In my sin, my heart was always rebelling. That's when God stepped in with a grace so compelling. Jesus, my one and only hope, his love's too strong to let me go. Jesus, my one and only hope. Once and for all,
Before we go, let's spend some time praying together. God, thank you for loving us despite our sin and brokenness. Help us love you more each day. Help us obey you and live joyfully in the freedom that you have given us through the new covenant and your Son. Amen.